Hallelujah. Oh, to God be the glory. Thank you, Lord. Glory be to God in the highest. Oh, Pale de Kamazwante Mahagadese Kibraha. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We thank God this very moment. It's a very awesome moment. It's a wonderful moment. It's a mighty time to rejoice in His presence. It's a time to be glad. It's a time to thank God for an opportunity in life that doesn't come every time, that come in such a time like this. It's a time to appreciate Him for His wonders. It's a time to give Him thanks and to give Him glory, because the Lord is good. He's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our thanks. Once again, viewer, once again, brothers and sisters, all over the world, watching me online this very moment, I've come your way again. Every Thursday like this, the Lord put in my heart to always come to share His word to His people all over. And what I'm doing right now is not just something I decided to be doing on my own. It's a command. It's something the Lord commanded me to do. And today I'm doing it because of you and because of your fulfillment. You need somebody, because when God is going to bless somebody, it doesn't come down by itself. He uses somebody. When the devil is also going to destroy, He also uses somebody. I'm glad tonight that I've been called by heaven. I've been summoned by heaven to come your way, to be a blessing to you and to your home. Please, you will be doing the Lord favor right now by inviting your family, inviting your friends, anyone close to you. I want you to invite them. And also, if it's not possible, you could invite somebody right now. I want you to share as you are live right now watching me. Share to your friend, share to everybody. Begin to share, let them also be a part and parcel of this blessing. Because the blessing of the Lord is for everybody. So as it comes to you, don't be stingy. I want you to share to your friend, send to them. Let them also be a participant of what God is going to do right now. Let them be a part and parcel of this blessing that is going to be coming into life and into family. And I know within the pit of my heart that today is a different day. And today will cause a revolution to the kingdom of darkness and bring a fulfillment to your life. Your life is going to be revolutionized. Your life is going to be transformed. You are going to be reinvigorated again. You are going to have strength. You are going to have that ability to be able to take the enemy after hearing God's word. The word of God is life, and the word of God will bring strength and energy to you in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you this moment as I come across the way of your children again. Today is another wonderful day, Thursday. Lord, I ask, oh God, that you use me as a channel. Lord, that you use me, oh God, as a vessel to reach everyone that have been appointed by heaven to, not just by accident, at this moment, to be with me live, to be a blessing and to be a partaker of the goodness of God. Because I know that today something great is going to happen. Lord, let something good happen. Those ones that are downtrodden, let them be uplifted. Those ones with a heavy body in their heart, oh God, let yoke break. Let resistance break in the name of Jesus. Let life be free right now. As the word of God penetrates the lesser being of His word, penetrate into our conscious and subconscious, let life never be the same again, to the glory of your name, in Jesus' name. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to share with you a message which I've captured: the storm is over. I want you to be with me. I want you to remain focused, because focus is very, very important in fulfilling destiny. Because one of the ways Satan can make you in order to fulfill your destiny is to give you distraction. And once you allow the devil to give you distraction, he can also give you direction. So Paul said, this one thing I do, I forget those things that are behind and I'm pressing forward. So please, whatever thing that bother you, whatever thing that give you headache, whatever thing that give you heart pains, so please just forget it and remain focused and you will be healed of all your wounds in the name of Jesus. Now, I said the storm word is over. This message is coming, it's a timely message. Is a bomb that is going to be deposited in the kingdom of darkness that is going to shut every door of attack against your life. Every arrow sent to you, I'm here as God's servant. Yes, to let you know that that storm that I've been sent to you, to your family, to your business, whatever it may be, in any endeavor of your life, it is over right now, in the name of Jesus. Quickly, I want to take my text from the book of Matthew 14. And we take our journey quickly from Matthew 14, verse 22. And the Bible says, straight away, Jesus constrained his disciple to get into a ship and to go before him into the other side while he sent the multitude away. May the Lord bless this word into our heart right now in the name of Jesus. Now, when we are talking about storm, what are we talking about? We are talking about a disaster. We are talking about a disturbances. When you go to your dictionary, we tell you that storm is a disturbance of the atmosphere that is caused by rain, by thunder, by windstorm, or whatever, or by lightning. A storm is something that brings destruction. A storm is something that brings havoc. Storm is something that is not a good word. You know, that's why you see some people will say they storm that person's house. For somebody to storm your house, it means it came there for a purpose. Now, we are talking about storm of life. Everyone, we have, in one way or the other, there is an area whereby we are battling with storm. Now, as you are hearing me right now, maybe you are sick. There is a sickness that you have been dealing with, and it's like people have left you to bear your cross alone. There are some doctors have told them that you have to manage it. There are some you have been on this problem. It could be sickness. You have tried even to the extent. There is no way that. There's nothing doctor could do again. There's nothing man could do. There's nothing physician could do. Because they have not left you to your faith. They have not told you, don't just worry. They are not telling you, sorry. But I'm glad to let you know, this is a storm of life. These are things you face. So in their matrimonial home, they face one storm or the other in their family line. Maybe some certain expectation that you'll be trusting God for, it has not manifested. Some of you, maybe you are in school. You couldn't pay your school fees. There are some, maybe there is a child of yours that the devil have taken captives and you are crying to God day and night that God should intervene in the life of that your child. This has storm. Storm come to every one of us in different areas. And what are the reasons? What are the purposes of this storm? Why do storm have to come? Do they just on their own come? No. Storm come for a reason. Like as I told you, that storm is a disturbances. Is an havoc. Is you know, there are different kind of storm. It comes to disturb you. It comes to make you to be diseased, not at ease. It comes to take you off balance. A storm is not something people wish. A storm is not something people pray for. But storm must come. Everybody have one storm on the other that we are fighting. But I'm glad to let you know that the storm of life is already over. I want you to begin to walk in your victory because Jesus has already stepped into your storm. Now, this is a scripture that you can bear with me where we just read in Matthew 14, 22. The Bible says, until Jesus asked his disciples, he said, now let us enter into the ship and go to the other side. Ladies and gentlemen, why was it that it was at the particular time Jesus and his disciples were going to the other side? That was when the storm came to meet them in the middle of the journey. The Bible says, while they were sailing, there arise a great storm in someone that it was so much that it beat upon the sheep that they were being tossed to and fro, that the disciple cried out and said, Master, we perish. So that was the storm that made them, because they were going to another level of life. Yes, every level of life, there is a devil that you must fight to be able to get to another level. You know, somebody in life who want to succeed, you must do everything possible to take a step, a giant step, a bold step, to be able to get to the other side of life. What is the other side of life? The other side of life means a side where you are more blessed. You are more, settled. The other side of life is better than where you are right now. It's a step you take to advance in life. The other side of life is a kind of a step you take into a better things, from where you are to another level of life. Hear me. There is nobody that wants to get to another side of life, that want to get to another level, that the devil will not fight at all costs, especially when you are a child of God. There are different storms. When storm comes, it's a hint that there is something that God has prepared for you. That is why that storm came. Storm comes to everybody. It's not because you are a bishop, it's not because you are a married church member. Everybody that carry destiny, everybody that have life, everybody that is assigned by God to fulfill destiny. These are the people that mostly that Satan brings storm against. I encourage you today, some of you, only God knows your secret prayer. You have cried enough. Your pillow are wet with tears as a result of some personal things you are fighting within you. You might look up, it's like up is too far from you. You might look to your left, nobody. You might look to your right, there's nobody. But I'm glad to let you know that Jesus Christ has already stepped into your storm. So when the disciple cried, when the storm came against them in the middle of the sea, the Bible says Jesus was sleeping in the inner part of the boat. Then, lo and behold, was Jesus Christ telling them that they should face the storm alone? No. Jesus Christ knew, because he was there, everything will be okay. I'm glad to let you know that everything, life will soon stabilize. That is why when you go to the river, when you fetch, you dip your whatever you took to the river to fetch water. And as you dip inside the water, you discover that after taking from the water, you discover that the dirt and everything, the river, the water becomes so bad. You see everything is, you see rubbish. You see the water is no more settled, it's no more pure, it's no more clear because you took from it. But when you exercise patience and lead you discover that after a while, the water will become calm. It will be pure again. That is life. Storm will come, storm will go. In life, there must be storm. But when Jesus Christ is in your boat, when Jesus Christ is in the affair of your life, every storm that has been sent to destroy you, that storm is what will catapult you to your enviable height. You have a destiny to fulfill. That is why you are facing this storm. The storm, whatever thing that cannot kill you will make you. I'm glad to let you know that this storm you are facing is not going to kill you. Whatever thing that cannot kill you now will make you stronger. God is preparing you for the next level. Every storm you are facing is for a while. There is nothing that lasts forever, because one with God is with majority. Every storm you are facing today, God is there with you, is preparing you for the next level. Take this into take it so seriously that when storm comes, it's a sign that you are ripe for your breakthrough. That is why the storm came. So what you need to do, what you got to do, is to take a step of faith to move a bit further. Then God will take a giant step and fulfill that your aspiration. What storm are you facing? Why are you crying? Stop crying. The storm is already over. I have been mandated by God to speak into your life today. Wherever place you are watching me, all over the world, I'm a servant of the Most High. I'm an end-time messenger. I've come to speak to your life that storm will never see the light of the day again. I've come to speak into your business, Your business will experience restoration again. I have come to speak into your children that are giving you cause for concern, that are giving you worry, that you are troubled about. Those your children, God is going to restore them. Restoration is coming to your home. Those people that have written you off, that have said, this one cannot amount to anything, I'm telling you today by the power of God, these same people will come back to you. They need to fill a form before they will see you. Those people that have written you off, that your life is over, nothing good can come out of Nazareth, I'm glad to let you know that these same people, they will be surprised to see what God is going to do in your life. Your life is a wonderful one, because Jesus said, they that the Father have given me, we are made for what? For signs and for wonder. You are not just born by mistake. You are not on earth here just because you are here. You are be summoned by eternity. So the earth needs you, and you must fulfill that purpose which you were born for. Let us go to the other side of life. I speak to you today by the grace of God. Take a step. Move a bit further. Don't give up on yourself. You are peculiar. There is no other person like yourself. That is why your thumbprint, nobody can have the same thumbprint like your own. That is why you are peculiar, you are a different person. God created you, and as long as you did not die while they were giving birth to you, it's a sign that you have a mission to fulfill on earth. And that destiny, you must fulfill it. Storm of life is coming to an end in your life right now. You have cried enough, but I'm hearing God telling me to tell you, don't cry again. It's a time of jubilation. It's a time of merriment. The reason why God allowed the storm to come is to let you know that you are important. Because somebody that is not important, the devil will not waste his precious time to attack the person or to bring storm to his life. It's because you are important. That is why you are facing storm. It's because you have somewhere you are headed to. That is why you are facing storm. But this storm has come to an end today by the power of God. It is over. It is over. And I'm glad to let you know that you and Jesus, you are a winner. You are an unbeatable team. Jesus is in your boat and is calming every storm. Jesus is the calmer of our troubled water. He's the stiller of our storm. He says, storm, be ceased. When they ran to him and said, Master, we perish. Don't you care? He said, I care. And Jesus said, why are you afraid as long as I'm here? Don't be afraid. Don't be worried. Let not your heart be troubled. One with God is with majority. As long as God is with you, you are a winner. As long as God is with you, you will make it. You will succeed. And Jesus came out and he looked to the storm and said, how dare you, devil? How dare you? How dare you, devil? Where were you when I created the river? Where were you when I created the whole world? And Jesus said, he said, storm, be still. Every storm in your life, be still in the name of Jesus. The storm of life is over. Things will become better for you from now. Things will be okay with you from now, because that storm is already over. You have no rival again, because God have already calmed your storm. There shall not be any storm again. Mark this word. Storm will come, storm will go. It's somebody that have destiny, that have where he's going to, that the devil will bring storm against. The reason why there is storm in your life is because you are peculiar, you are unique, you are a special person, you are a royal priesthood, a peculiar nation. You have been called by God to do something great, to cause a change. Your storm is over right now, and may the Lord bless you. This same time next week, I will also be your way again on Thursday next week, because the Lord asked me to do this. People must be healed. People must be delivered. People that have given up on themselves, they must come bounce back to life again. It is well with you. It is well with your business. It is well with your home. Your storm is over. In Jesus' name, amen.